conditions. Conditions will give output as true or false. Based on this output, we can decide what action should be performed. There are four types of conditions, that is if, if else, nested if and switch. If, if else, nested if. First we'll see about if. Inside if we have some condition. So if this condition is true, means this statement will be executing, or else it will come out of this. Then if else. Inside if else also we have if condition. So if this condition is true, this part will be executing. If this condition fails, then it will come to else part. So it will be executing this condition fails part. Then nested if. Nested if will have two ifs within that. Like first if condition 1. This condition 1 is true, it will check. If that is true, it will come inside. Then it will check if condition 2 is true. If that is also true, means then it will print condition is true. That is, it will execute whatever actions inside this condition 2. But if our condition 2 fails, then up to this condition 1, it will go out. Consider condition 1 also failed. Then it will not come inside any of this. It will go out. Let's see one example program for condition. For that, we have taken one class called test. Inside that class, we have one variable int x equal to 10. And to check the condition, we have if else. So inside if, whatever condition we have, if that is true, based on that, inside if whatever it is there, it will print. If that is failed, means then else part will be executed. So here x equal to 10, it is checked. Our x value is 10. So 10 equal to 10, it will be comparing. So both are true. It will give us entered value is 10, since it is true output. Switch case. Switch case also condition only, but if else and nested if will be similar. Syntax of them will be similar, but switch case syntax will be somewhat different. Now let's see it. Switch expression case value 1. So based on the output, it will print whatever statements inside this value 1. If that output is value 2, means inside value 2 whatever it is there, it will print. We can have any number of statements like this. And if none of the values matches, then it will print whatever we have given in default. Now let's see one example program for switch case. For that, we have taken one class called test. And inside that, we have one variable char grade equal to b. And we are checking switch of grade. We are passing this variable. And we have some conditions here. Case a, case b, case f and default. So here, case A if we got, it should print excellent. Case B if we got, it should print you passed. Case F means better try again. And if none of the cases are there, then it will print default, that is invalid grade. So here our grade is B. So this switch of B, it will come. So our case B here, you passed. So this will be printing here.